This is a losing game for me because I can't tell what any of these smells are. Coconut perfume department grandma house floral.
Well, it probably seems like it's bright and early, but actually it's not that early. The kids are already on the bus. I already did my yoga class. It's just December. That's how it goes. There's not much light around here. We are fast approaching the solstice. And after that, there's a little bit of hope. You know, the days get a little longer, maybe just by seconds each day. But by February, you start to notice. And that's when you start to really get going on the garden planning. And you know, when I think about the garden, I'm really glad it's only December. Honestly, I'm still tired. I'm so grateful for all of the good foods that we grew and all, you know, get to put into our bodies. It's all full of light and it's all full of love, but it does take a toll on you physically. And this is the time of the year when you can recuperate. The knitting and spinning and restorative exercises just make sense. Yeah, so here we are out for our walk. I'll maybe be able to catch a sunrise for you.
That's a good thing. Oh, there he is. No, Lila, no, I mean Tilly, you're not Lily. Are you okay, buddy? Oh, poor little, oh, Tilly, you got him good. Oh.
I think he's just in shock, a little shook up. I didn't feel anything that was felt too broken or broken at all, actually, and I didn't see any blood. So, let's find a hill. Well, you poor little thing. This is a, you can see the teeth there. Teeth. And the claws, that's a mole. Blind. And they just make tunnels. Don't want them in the garden, but we're nowhere near the garden, so let's find him a safe place to recover.
He didn't make it. Tilly must have done something to his lungs. Maybe cracked a rib or something, I don't know, but anyway. There's a word in Sanskrit, moksha. It means soul's speedy departure and arrival. Departure from the body, arrival in the afterlife. Sometimes death is inevitable and it's never pleasant. But when we can send a creature off with reverence, respect, and wishes for a speedy movement into the afterlife, it sometimes helps. So, moksha, little buddy.
Hello. The tea today is a chocolate mint, and it's a chocolate mint rooibos. It's different, but I'm enjoying it quite a bit more than yesterday's tea. I'll definitely finish this one. Yeah. So, we had a bit of an adventure this morning on our walk. You just never know what you're going to get when you leave the house, and it's not a reason to stay home. It can't be based in fear, but yeah, sometimes adventures happen. When I lived in Vancouver and I was going to school, it was about a probably 45-minute walk, and I did have a car for a while there. But it was just easier and nicer to walk. I mean, Vancouver, my goodness, if you've ever been there, it's green most of the year. Snowfall is like a freak thing. It rarely happens. And when it does, you know, the whole city shuts down, which is kind of funny. But anyway, I enjoyed my walks and I walked quite frequently. But when you leave the house, sometimes things happen, right? So I was walking down the street and I saw this lump on the ground. I didn't know what it was. By the time I got there, there was one other person there. And it turns out it was an elderly man who had Maybe had a heart attack, not really sure, but collapsed on his looked like what was probably his morning walk. We both knew CPR, so she did the mouth, I did the chest compressions, and we did that until the EMS arrived, and then we were just sent on our way. Just kept walking to school. It was so weird, actually. I thought maybe it would be nice for the family to hear our story, just to know what happened. Maybe it was irrelevant. Well, I guess EMS thought it probably was irrelevant. They didn't even get our names or numbers or anything. Nothing. Yeah, so that's what I mean. Like, when you leave the house, you just don't know what's going to happen today till you found a mole. And yeah, did her thing. So on that happy, positive note, let's see what is in the store for us on day number 6. I think it's going to be a little bit more blue. Hey, oh, it's really blue. Look at that. Beautiful. So this was yesterday. This is today. And to compare to day 1, there. So we're definitely getting into those nice, cool blues. I can't wait to knit with this. I will be doing that as soon as we finish up here. I have a few minutes. Well, more than a few minutes, like probably an hour before I have to go to work, so yay. All right, which Queen song will it be today?
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey, gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust.
Number 6, found it. Let's see what we got. Oh, cute. This is a brownie color. The brand is Dirty Water Dye Works. The yarn name is Lillian and the color is wheat. Gosh, I haven't heard of most of these. This is so fun and exciting to be exposed to new yarns, new products. And she's so wonderful because she labels everything. So you can see exactly what it is. And I just pin those labels on and put them into my Christmas Advent bag and we'll make something up that's really cool and special. You can see we've got quite a few in there already. Right on. Okay, well, I think probably today is Wednesday. I think Saturday I'm going to do something for a giveaway. So that'll be fun. We'll be able to give away the first of our 2 prizes for Advent this year. Very, very exciting. All right, I'm off to knit. We'll talk to you later. Bye.
Chemistry is on and I'm sitting by the fire, just gonna pick up my knitting and enjoy the rest of the evening. So I'll see you tomorrow.